Good morning, students. In last week, we have completed schedule number 4. In schedule number 4, we learn about the separation methods, various separation methods, how it is useful for us, and if in front of any mixture, then which method we will use to separate it. Okay, so some separation methods we learn in that. Still, two or three new separation methods for you. It is not there in your regular syllabus in 6th standard, but that all separation methods are there in 8th standard. So chromatography, then fractional distillation and crystallization, these three separation methods we will learn when you will come in the schools, because there are some practicals are there, and for that we have to adjust so many setups and all. So in lab only that we will conduct. Okay, if you will get any information related to that, means that points, just read it. So when we will conduct the practicals and when I will explain you, that time you will understood better. Okay, so whatever the method completed, that all methods, just read it, revise it again. See, if one schedule completed, then we will start the next schedule, but you revise every day, read that all lessons, whatever the lessons completed. So today we will start the next schedule, that is schedule number 5, and in this schedule number 5 we are going to learn new lesson water. See, this actually in this schedule number 5 there are lessons, that is water and air. Okay, so first we will start water lesson. This lesson is there in your textbook, means CBSE, which one now we use regularly. Okay, lesson number 14, water. When I will complete any point here, then that point you read from a textbook and write important points in your notebook. Okay, now see, in this lesson, water lesson. Now water, everyone you know that how the water is essential for us, how it is important for us. Okay, because whatever we are doing the daily activities since morning to till, means when we will go to the sleep till, that mostly we are using the water. So water is too much important for us. Okay, so there are some uses of water. Now what, you just write 10 uses of the water, whatever, any uses you just write, take a 5 minutes and write uses, and then again you continue this lecture. Okay, uses of water, just think that which use, means for what purpose water we use every day. See, the mostly, see, the some uses are common use, means what, washing clothes, washing utensils. Okay, and the most important, that is for the drinking purpose, because drinking water is so necessary. So these are the some common uses. See here, the first point I written, that is the drinking, cooking, washing clothes and utensils. These are the common examples. See, don't write that like this. It means first use washing clothes, second use washing utensils, third use for drinking purpose. Don't write that way, because now you are in 6th standard. So write some different uses. Okay, just think in detail in that. Okay, so this is the first use, means common use. Every day we are washing clothes, utensils, then so many things. Okay, we are doing every day. Then now the second, it is the use in the industries. Now in industries they use the water. See, what is the function of industries, means what they are doing. See, in industries they make a different things. Okay, so for that purpose they need a lot of water. Without water they can't make anything, because water is more important. See, in our daily life also, whenever your mother is preparing food, without water she can prepare food? No, it is impossible. Okay, so water is very important. So she is also using water and then she prepared the food. For the same way in the industries they use the water to prepare the so many things, okay? So many products, what they are the preparing for that purpose, water is very important. And see, water is important for the cleaning process also. If one day water will not come, then what is the condition in our house? See, do you are observing only daily, okay? So for that also water is important. Now see the next third point, it is the transportation. Now transportation means what? You know, in the whole world, okay, 70%, mostly 70% covered by the water. So sea and oceans, in that a lot of water is there, okay? So for the transportation means to transport one product to the another country or somewhere else. So for that process also water we use, means oceans. Maybe whenever you are going for the vacations, that time you done the boating and all, okay? So this is also the one use of the water. Water is help for the transportation of goods, okay? Then the next point, it is the growth of plants. See, now plants, you know, plants are much important for us. Without plant means oxygen, and they give us oxygen, that is the very important. And see, whatever we are eating in daily, since morning, breakfast, lunch, dinner, so that all the food we are getting from a plant. But how this plant will grow? For the growing plants, for growth of the plant, what is important? Water is important, okay? Without water, plants can't grow because they need water. So see, the main point, the main is a water. If water will be not there, then how plants will grow? And if plants will not grow, then we will not get water, will not get any product, means the food items whichever we are using in daily, that we will not get the fruits, will not get the vegetables, okay? So for the germination of seed or for growing plants, development for the plants, water is very essential. Understood? Okay. Now see the next point, that is to generate electricity. See, in the fifth standard, we learn about the hydroelectricity. Do you remember that hydroelectricity? Now hydroelectricity means what? The electricity which produced from water, that is known as a hydroelectricity. Okay, so the water is essential for that also, means with the help of water we can generate the electricity. And what is the use of electricity? You everyone all you know, okay? Without electricity, I mean, see, whatever the things, whichever it is present, see, electricity is now our the daily. Without electricity we can't see TV also. Then washing machine will not work. Now see, now also you are using the mobile or maybe the smart TV or laptop to see this video. So for that also, what is important? Electricity. Without electricity you can see this? No. So electricity also, to generate the electricity, water is very important. Okay, so there are the so many uses. These all are the uses, the common use. Okay, these all are the uses of water. So water is given for your syllabus. It is, see, whatever the text means, whatever the points, it is given for you. That is not only to by heart the answer, to write in the textbook. No, these all you take it positively. Okay, so because of that you save water. Unnecessarily don't waste water. Because see, now you are learning about the uses of water, we will learn the importance of water. So water is very important for us, okay? So don't waste water. Now the next point we will see, that is the importance of water. Now in importance of water, what? See, water is a good solvent. See, now this solvent, solute and solution we learned in the last lesson. So water is a good solvent means what? The most of the substances soluble in water means dissolving water. So water is known as a good solvent. Okay, so this is the first important. Water is a good solvent. Then see, it regulates our body temperature. See, it regulates our body temperature means what? It maintains our body temperature. Means whenever we are drinking the water, then it maintains our body temperature properly. See, sometimes what happens if we are not feeling well, okay, and if we will not drink the enough water, how is our condition? We feel very weakness, okay, so many the symptoms are there, and then sometimes dehydration also, so many the diseases also cause. So whenever you will go for the doctor for the treatments, what they suggest is drink more water, okay. See, you observe it, every time they are suggesting us to drink more water. So why we have to drink more water? To regulate, to maintain our body temperature. Now how much the body temperature, that we learned last year also, okay, you know that. So the for to maintain the body temperature, we need the water. And you know, the mostly the 70% weight of our body, that is the water, because more amount of water only present in our body, okay. And how it's regulate the temperature? See, whenever we are doing a lot of work, so sometimes sweat comes out, okay, means that sweat means what? It is the excretory product, whichever the water used in our body, that is the waste water our body is throw out, so in the form of urine and sweat, because these are the excretory, okay, that you learn in biology also. So it's regulate our body temperature, means how to maintain the body temperature? Sweat and urine, means whenever the used water, which is now the waste water, is there in our body, that comes out in the form of sweat and urine, okay. So it helps to maintain our body temperature. Now see the third point, that is useful in photosynthesis process. Now what is a photosynthesis? See, photosynthesis means what? This process for in the plant, means plants are making their food with the help of photosynthesis. So for the photosynthesis process, they need sunlight. Sunlight, then chlorophyll is present in plants, means that green color that everyone you know that. And the water, means what? Water is important for the photosynthesis process. Means here also, at home, how our, if water will be not available, we can't prepare a food. The same way, if water will be not available, plants cannot make their food. So water is important even in the photosynthesis process also. Okay, to gather the minerals and all, they absorb the minerals, salt, and now again I will not go in detail in that. So photosynthesis process means what? To prepare food. Okay, means plants are preparing food by their own in the plants. So for that purpose also, water is important. So what we learn today? What are the uses of water and importance of water? So see, because of these so many points, the water are very important for us. So at least today onwards, you don't waste water. Whatever you necessary, that much only you take. Okay, unnecessarily don't keep contacts and all. Then today these 2 points completed, that is the uses of water and importance. Here I given only some uses, some just example, but if you will get an extra point, you just observe it our surrounding and write more uses in your notebook, okay, daily, and read related to this point. It is given in your textbook. Read textbook. Next point we will continue in next one.